Remember how yesterday Joseph was a good guy, and that got him thrown into prison. But where was God in this? The Bible says that the Lord was with him, but did his imprisonment really serve any purpose? Surely Joseph must have wondered this. His reaction can be found in Genesis 40:15. "For I was forcibly carried off from the land of the Hebrews, and even here I have done nothing to deserve being put in a dungeon." Now, how is he rewarded? A prison sentence with no hope of parole. However, he wasn't the last to experience what at first might seem unfair. But look how God used him and others. For example, Paul was in prison, but it was from there that he wrote our epistles. John was exiled to an island, but there he gave us a glimpse into heaven. Jesus was crucified for doing nothing wrong, but look at the hope we have today of eternal salvation. To paraphrase Max, intended evil can become ultimate good. Now, we might wonder with Joseph why certain things have happened or are happening now in our lives. Where is God in all of this? While we might be puzzled, God can and will use this for his good purpose, if we just let him. Joseph's life is a good example. From an earthly point of view, his life had come to a tragic conclusion. The devil had him exactly where he wanted him. But so did God. What Satan intended for evil, God was using for testing. You know, every day we are tested through people, pain, or problems. These tests are used by God for his glory and our maturity. Keep in mind that while each day is a pop quiz, those quizzes are preparing us for the final exam. So, why didn't God keep Joseph out of prison? We might find the answer over there in James, where we read there in the first chapter, these verses. "Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of any kind, because you know that a testing of your faith develops perseverance, and perseverance must finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything." See, Joseph didn't complain, but displayed compassion for the frowns on the faces of Pharaoh's imprisoned butler and baker. Abandoned by his brothers, sold into slavery, unjustly imprisoned, Joseph was still compassionate toward others. He interpreted their dreams, and one of them remembered later, and that got him out of prison and back into Pharaoh's house. Now, I don't know what kind of test you're going through right now. Keep in mind that the Hebrew verb for test means to take keen look at. God is looking at you, knowing that you'll get through this. As Max says, if God can make a prince out of a prisoner, he can make something good out of you. You see, God wasn't finished with Joseph yet, and he's not yet finished with you. Let us pray. Lord, we know that we are not finished with Joseph, that you had more for him and you have more for us. May we pass the test of life until the final exam of eternal life. This we pray as your Son, Jesus, our Savior, taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Well, if you don't remember anything else, please remember this. Life is a test. Let's keep the faith and pass the test. And God bless you. Amen.